Today, by the grace of God, we are here to celebrate the foundation stone ceremony of our first purpose-built mosque project in Galway, Masjid Maryam Mary Mosque. It is also a momentous and historic day for us that our beloved Caliph, the Supreme Head of the worldwide Ahmadiyya Muslim community, His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad Ayyadullah Ta'ala bin Nasr al-Aziz, Khalifat al-Masih the Fifth, graciously accepted our invitation for this ceremony. It is therefore my great privilege and honor to extend my heartfelt thanks and appreciation to him for attending this function despite his extremely busy schedule.
Of charity and of tolerance and compassion guides you in all aspects of your lives. The core values of your community, love for all, hatred for none, are values which we can share.
This occasion is a good opportunity to build bridges of friendship based on mutual respect, understanding of cultures, and to work together for common values. I have no doubt that the mosque will help foster interfaith relations between people from different faiths, backgrounds, ethnicities living alongside in our society. I wish the Ahmadiyya Muslim community every success with this new historical initiative, and I am very pleased that it is taking place here in the city of Galway.
I think that in the world which we now face, which requires all of our efforts, it requires both our belief systems and our rational reason systems and scientific achievements to deal with climate change, to deal with world poverty, to deal with the abuse of human rights, requires that kind of openness and those kind of values that are stressed always by the Ahmadiyya community when we meet them.
But I was also very, very pleased on meeting Imam Noonan's a couple of months ago description of the mosque as a broader symbol of peace, combining elements of Islam with Irish features. It is very uplifting to hear that you intend to use the mosque not only as a place of worship, but also as a building used to forge community relationships.
When looking at the background and the history of the Ahmadiyya community, I see a number of common factors between it and An Garda Síochána. Our commitment to community policing is mirrored in the Ahmadiyya's enthusiastic commitment to community and community cohesion. As a religion, you have an avowed code of peace where you espouse love and peace and reject hatred. So similarly, An Garda Síochána strives for this ethos, and indeed when translated from the Gaelic, the term Garda Síochána means guardian of the peace. I have been impressed by the community's constant condemnation of violence in the strongest possible terms, the manner in which you have embraced all communities, and how you have developed a spirit of allegiance to the country in which you reside.
May we, as different communities, may we grow in friendship and build many bridges of peace in Galway and beyond. That's my wish and prayer for us as we gather this evening to celebrate the laying of the foundation stone for the new mosque in Galway. Thank you.
In this age, we Ahmadis consider the founder of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad of Qadian, on whom be peace, to be the promised Messiah. We believe that to the world to establish goodness and to bring people closer to God Almighty. In any case, what I wish to say is that those who want to find the true reality are able to find the truth through research and effort. It would make it clear that terrorism has no religion, nor does any religion sanction murder in its name. When the places of worship of all religions are in one place, it will be a declaration that no religion teaches unlawful killing. And Islam is also a religion of peaceful teachings, whose purpose is to remind man about the rights of God and the rights owed to human beings. The only meaning of Islam is love, affection, and brotherhood. If this is the only meaning of Islam, then how could it be that we do not live with other religions in love, affection, and brotherhood? And we, the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, follow this principle and believe in the peaceful solution to all matters in places where the Jamaat or the community is well established. This fact is well known. In fact, our relations with the church are such that if our mosque cannot hold the entire congregation, they let us use their halls, and I myself have once led prayers in this church hall. It is clear, therefore, that Muslims are not the terrorists that are portrayed by the wrong deeds of certain Muslims for their own interests and who act against the teachings of Islam. In fact, true Muslims are ambassadors of peace. No religion of the world advocates cruelty or barbarism, because religion comes directly from God, and God loves his creation very much. This is what we also learn from the Holy Quran.
It was lovely to be here. It was lovely to meet His Holiness. He seemed to be a very pleasant, deep, peaceful man. It was great to hear him.
I think His Holiness is very interesting in so far as that he emphasized the basic teaching in the Quran as a gospel of peace.
It was a great pleasure to have had the privilege to sit beside him at the meal and to converse with him, and I'm very, very impressed with him as a person.
He also spoke issues openly and honestly, which I was delighted to hear, particularly because of the importance of his position.
First of all, his speech was very powerful, it was very strong. It was very poignantly clear that his principles and his following is about peace.